to praise the Lord. Today is a good day to praise the Lord and give a shout unto God.
And the Lord of Lords, won't you me and
is worthy. He is worthy. When I think about where God has brought me from, I can't help but praise Him. I can't help but worship Him. I can't help but adore Him. Who is man that you are mindful of Him, God? Who is the Son of Man that you love Him so? Come on and raise a worship in the sanctuary this morning.
Because my God. and his mercy shall endure. Because my God is good. Ah, has he been good to you? And his mercy, yes, his mercy, his tender mercy, they are new every morning. When I wake up in the morning, I step into the mercies of God. When I wake up in the morning, I step into the goodness of God. That is why I love him. That is why I praise him. That is why I worship him. That is why I adore him. His mercies are new every morning.
Hallelujah. In eternity, we shall be worshiping. We shall be worshiping continuously. The Bible says in Revelation that the 24 elders, they are clothed in white. They have crowns on their heads. When they see the different dimensions, the different types of majesty, the different beauty of God, they cast down their crowns before him and they say, "You are worthy, O God, to receive glory, to receive honor, to receive power, to receive dominion forever and ever. For you created all things, and by all things they were created." And then I go into Isaiah and I saw where Isaiah said, in the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord. He was high and lifted up. The train of his robe, it filled the temple. And the seraph, they had six wings. With two they covered their faces. With two they covered their feet. And with two they were flying. And they cried, "Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord God of all creation. The whole earth is filled with your glory." Come on, open your mouth and magnify the name of the Lord. Cry out, say, "You are holy, God. You are righteous, God. You are amazing, God. There is none like you, God." Hallelujah.
I enter the holy of holies. I enter through the blood of the Lamb. I enter to worship you only. I enter to honor I am. I will sing it again. I enter the holy of holies. I enter through the blood of the Lamb. I enter to worship you, oh Lord. I enter. Holy, holy, Lord, I enter. name, your name, your name is holy.
Glorious,
so glorious,
glorious. Yahweh, 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 Yahweh.
Glorious.
You are. Yes, you are glorious.
You are glorious.
None like you.
So glorious. In your ways.
You are glorious. You are glorious. Yes, you are. Hey, yeah, yeah, hey, yeah, yeah, hey, yeah, hey, yeah, yeah, hey, yeah, yeah, hey, yeah.
Happy to be in the presence of God this morning. Amen. I'm happy as well. It's truly a privilege and an honor to worship God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Come on and just give God a wave offering. If you want, you can blow him a kiss too. Come on, we bless you, Jesus.
We worship you.
To worship you, I live. To worship you, I live. I live to worship you. To worship you, I live. To worship you, I live. I live to worship you.
Father, we love you. Father.
on and lift your voices. Come on, just take 60 seconds, not even 30 seconds, and just lift your voices. Come on. The Lord is listening to you this morning. He's hearing your cry this morning. Come on and just take a minute and just express yourself. God is in the room this morning. Come on. Come on. Boast about your master. Come on. Hey. Yet I'm a you are Yahweh. 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 one more time. Come on, tell him. Come on and worship him.
We give you all. We give you glory.
For if it had not been for the Lord on our side, I don't know about you, but for me, if it had not been for the Lord on my side, when men rose up against me, they would have swallowed me alive. The waters would have overwhelmed me. And so if God has spared me to see the month of June, the last Sunday of June, I have every cause. I have every reason to give him the praise and the glory. Listen, all I have needed, all you may have needed, he hasn't provided for you, but you are still here. You are still alive. You were not one of the statistics. We have every cause and every reason to give him praise and to give him all the glory. He is worthy to be praised. The psalmist said, bless the Lord, all my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, all my soul, and forget not. And forget not. And forget not all his benefits. What has God done for you? What has he done for you? For somebody, he healed all your disease. For somebody, he delivered you from destruction. for somebody, the car that drove in front of you, it could have been your car. You would have been in that accident. He said, and forget not. This morning, we remember. We have come this morning to remember. To remember all that he has done for us. His daily provision. His daily deliverance. His daily promotion that he has bestowed upon you and that he has bestowed upon us. And so I believe that it is a good time. It is an amazing time for you and I to come before his throne, to worship him and to adore him. We are giving him all the glory due him. We are giving him all the honor due him. Because if you, regardless of where you find yourself now, God is a good God. Regardless of how you see your situation, he is still a good God. We have been kept by the power of God. It is not by our mind, it is not by our power, but by his spirit. And so this morning, we have come to adore his name. This morning, we have come to give him all the praise. Forget about yourself. Forget about who stands to your left or to your right. And give him uninhibited praise and worship. You see, there's a scripture in... it's good to shout. He may be shouting, you don't understand, but he knows why he is shouting. Exodus 15. You may take your seats for a few minutes. Exodus 15. You see, worship is one thing that Satan hates most. And I believe that it is for three reasons. Number one, it magnifies the Lord for who he is and for his mighty works. So the enemy hates it when you and I come to God in worship. It also reminds the enemy of what he has, of what he was created to do and how he lost it. And so when he lost it and we took it from him, he doesn't like it when we come before his throne to worship the Maker. The third point is that it releases the power to thwart his efforts against the people of God. Anytime we meet, anytime we worship, it releases some sort of power to thwart the efforts of the enemy. You see, one thing the enemy cannot stand is to see God's people capture the revelation about what it means to be a worshiper. The enemy can't stand that, because if we have the revelation, if we capture the revelation of what it means to be a worshiper, it doesn't matter where we find ourselves. It doesn't matter what we are going through. We will still praise him. We will still worship him. You see, worship has implications on us and our circumstances. When we worship, we create a manifest presence of God where he does things that we may not humanly do. That is the kind of God that you and I serve. And so in Exodus chapter number 15, Exodus 15, I'm reading from verse 1 to 3 and then I'll jump to 11. Then Moses and the children of Israel sang this song to the Lord and spoke, saying, I will sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. The horse and its rider he has thrown into the sea. The Lord is my strength and song. He has become my salvation. Verse number 3. He is my God, and I will praise him. My father's God, and I will exalt him. The Lord is a man of war. The Lord is his name. Verse number 11. is like you, O Lord, among the gods? Who is like you? Glorious in holiness, fearful in praises, doing wonders. Who is like you, O Lord? Who is like you among the gods? He is glorious in holiness, fearful in praises, doing wonders. Amen. You see, this is an account of how the children of Israel expressed their praise after Pharaoh and his choice chariots were overthrown into the Red Sea. Moses acknowledged that the deliverance that God took them through, it wasn't them that did it, it was God. He demonstrated his mighty power in the salvation story. At the heart of it all, it was their praise to God. You see, we will be deceived to think that the first 30 minutes of our church coming, or when we come to church, the first 30 minutes is not part of the service. The first 30 minutes where we give passionate, we praise God, where we demonstrate our worship to God, where we thank God, where passionately we praise God for who he is and for what he has done in our lives. We will be deceived. You and I will be deceived that doesn't matter to God. We will be deceived to think that it is only the word of God that matters. Praise and worship, that active break of praise and worship that we give to God every Sunday, matters to God. Because the truth is, most of the activities in our gathering are for us. Most of the activities that we do here in our gatherings, they are not for God. The word of God is for us. The word of God is supposed to come and transform our lives. The word of God is supposed to come into our life and lift us from one level of faith to another. The ministration that we minister, it is for you and it's for me. The fellowship, the encouragement that we receive every Sunday, it is for us. It is not for God. The only part that belongs to the Lord is our praise and worship. By the way, when I say praise and worship, our giving is also part of praise and worship. Our giving, we give to his mission. And so that is the part that God requires us to give back to him. Because God does not need his word. Because after all, he is the word. For in the beginning was the word, and the word was with God. God does not need encouragement because he sits in his own class and he does that which pleases him. You see, what brings him pleasure and delight is our worship. That is when his holy ones bring him pure, unrestricted, and heartfelt worship and adoration. And that is what we are going to do this morning. We started already, and we are going to continue. In Psalm number 22, verse number 3, Scripture says that, "But you are holy, enthroned in the praises of Israel." God is enthroned in our praises. Anytime we praise the Lord, anytime we worship him, he is enthroned in it. In other words, he sits in our praise and it sits in our worship. I want us to note two things from the scripture we read in Exodus, and I'll sit down. In Exodus chapter number 15, 1-2, there are two key words that I want us to look at: strength and song. Strength and song. You see, Moses understood the revelation that within their song of praise and worship was the strength of God. When they sang, power was released to overthrow the Egyptian army. When we sing songs of praise to our God, the power to do exploits is manifest. When we sing songs of praises to our God, breakthroughs happen. When we sing songs of praises, when we worship our God, birthing occurs. When we sing songs of praises, when we worship, power is manifest to do the impossible. When we sing songs of praises to our God, tyranny is overthrown. And I want somebody to get this. Never forget this, that music was created by God himself. Don't think that the enemy created music. Music was created by God himself. You see, when John caught the revelation into heaven on the island of Patmos, he saw that there was non-stop worship. Worship was continuous 24/7 around the throne of grace. And so music, God created music for us to worship him, for us to adore him 24/7. I don't know about you, but have you wondered that when you're in your darkest time, when you are in a time of depression, when you put on uplifting music, when you put on uplifting words, your spirit is energized. That is what music will do to you, and that is what music will do to me. And so I want to encourage somebody, in your dark times, don't go into your room, turn off your, you know, bring down all your blinds, turn off your lights, fold, you know, put your head under your duvet, and then begin to cry. No. Sing some joyful songs to God. Make some joyful noise to God. Put on some uplifting music, because for me, once I have music around, there is no way that I'll be depressed. Not at all. Last week, I was speaking to somebody, and she was telling me her experience, that she went to the doctor, and the doctor gave her a bad report. And when she came home, she closed all her blinds, 2 o'clock, went to bed, and started crying. And I'm like, what happened to your music? What happened to your song? And I told her, it's something that the doctor said. He didn't say it was there. She said there is a possibility. And what God, what kind of God that do you serve? Because the doctor didn't say it was there. She didn't even say it was a 50% chance. And I asked her, why do you allow the enemy to get to you? Anytime the enemy comes to you, there is a song in your mouth. Even if you don't have any song, turn on something. Your spirit will be energized. Your spirit will be uplifted. It doesn't matter your voice. Sometimes we think, for us that, you know, don't sing like a Kharis expression. Anytime we begin to sing, we think God will not listen or God will not hear us. God will still hear us. It doesn't matter if we bend the song. It doesn't matter if we roast the song. It doesn't matter if our voices are not good or not good. At the end of the day, we are singing to God. We are praising God in the beauty of the holy of his holiness. And so it doesn't matter your voice. Yesterday, when we went somewhere up the other side of town, and Ernest was leading Ernest was leading us in a time of hymns and praise, and he said, "Mommy, my voice." I said, "Go ahead and sing. God is listening." And so in 2 Chronicles chapter number 20, verse 22, Judah found themselves in a tight place. 3 nations had invaded them. They didn't know what to do. Naturally, they stood no chance. But the Lord showed them that even though they were outnumbered physically, they had a superior power. You may be outnumbered physically this morning, but you have a superior power. Verse 22 says that when they began to sing and praise, the Lord set ambushes against the men of Moab, against the men of Seir, and against the men of Ammon. Listen, I want to tell you that there is power in your song. There is power in your praise. There is power in your mouth. In Psalm number 137, Psalm 137, it's a very popular song, Psalm 137, that says that by the rivers of Babylon, there we sat down, yea, we wept. You see, Babylon stands for confusion. Babylon stands for captivity. At that place, Israel lost their song. They hung their instruments of praise on trees, and their captors were mocking at them. Their captors were ridiculing them. Their captors told them, they baited them, please sing us the Lord's song. And they said, how can we sing the Lord's song in this situation? Listen, I want to tell somebody, don't lose your song because of your present situation. Because of what you are going through, you are losing your song. I want to encourage you, don't lose your song. Don't let the tongues of the enemy silence you. Don't focus so much on what you have. But I want you to focus on the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. The one that promised you, the one that promised me that I will never leave you nor forsake you. For weeping may endure. Whatever you are going through is temporary. For our light affliction, which works in us a far more exceeding weight of eternal glory. Whilst we look at the things that are seen, whatever you are looking at right now, whatever you are going through your life right now, I want to tell you that it's subject to change. I want to tell you that it is temporary. And so don't lose your song. Never permit anybody to silence you. No matter what, sing. No matter what, praise. No matter what, as a child of God, worship Him. Because in your singing, in your praising, in your worship, you confuse the enemy. Because the enemy doesn't understand why I am praising God in my situation. He knows what I'm going through, but I am still lifting up my hands. I am still praising. I am still magnifying. It confuses him. He's saying, I've done a number on me. I've done a number on her. But she is still praising God. She is still adoring God. Don't lose your song. Because anytime you sing, you break strongholds. Anytime you sing, you change the atmosphere. Anytime you sing, you change the climate. Don't lose your song because there is power in your mouth. Anytime you sing, things will turn around for your good. And so as we enter into the next phase of our praise and worship, I want to encourage you to be involved in what we are doing. Don't just sit down asking yourself many questions because of what you are going through. Give it your all, because when you sing, God comes through for you to do amazing things for you. Listen, He is our strength. He is our song. I don't know about you, but he has become my salvation. The Lord is my strength. For the joy of the Lord is my strength. Wherever you find yourself today, whatever you are going through, don't lose your song. Don't lose your praise, because it is only temporary. It is subject to change. The Lord is my strength. I don't care, I'll roast it, but the Lord.
Lord is my strength and my song. My song.
Keep waving, don't stop. We give you glory, Jesus. The Bible says, clap your hands, oh ye people, and make a joyful noise. Hey. Everybody say, you, Lord, you, Lord, you are worthy.
Worship you for me.
This hymn says, 'Tis so sweet to trust in Jesus, just to take Him at His word, just to lean upon His promise, just to know thus says the Lord.' Somebody call His name. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust Him, how I prove Him more and more. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus. Oh, for grace. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust Him. The glory, great things He has done. So loved He the world that He gave us His Son. Who yielded His life and atoned for sin and opened the light that you and I can come in. Let it just prostrate for us. Given us a name that is above every other name. At that name, every knee shall bow. Every tongue confess that Jesus is Lord. Somebody just lift your hands. We give you glory, Jesus. Power to save.
You are mighty, oh,
Oh, yeah.
Possible. And so I give him all the praise and the honor. It continues in the next service. Impact service. So if you want to stay, stay behind. I'm sure it will even get better. Amen. Amen. You want to make your offerings and your tithes ready. Don't forget, it's also part of our worship to God. You want to give your best. You want to honor God with your substance. You want to honor God and you want to tell God, thank you. Thank you for protecting me. Thank you for saving me. Thank you for delivering me. You want to say thank you with your substance. And so I encourage you to give your best. Amen.
I trust that your week has been very good. I know it's been quite a busy weekend. It's been busy for me too. I'm not with you today again. Apostolic duties, I'm actually on a rescue mission, and it was necessary that I had to do that. Like the Apostle Paul said, that I had to come your way to do something. And so I'm away today, but I want to take this opportunity to thank all of you for all the things that you've done this past weekend. I'm sure you can see there's been new developments in the sanctuary. It's looking beautiful, isn't it? I want to say thank you to our facilities department, Minister Ben. God richly bless you for what you have done. You know, it's still not finished. We are getting ourselves ready. You know, everything is new, it's beautiful. That is what we stand for, the excellence that honors our God. I also want to remind you about ISI 2023, our flagship event. You do not want to miss this. And you know, we are way ahead of the ball, but you are not ahead of the ball. Register, please register. Download the app, go on our site, register, invite people. It's going to be amazing. This level of speakers is epic. It's going to be amazing. So let's do that. And I'll see you very soon. Pray for me as I pray for you. God richly bless you. Bye-bye.
Hello, everyone. On behalf of our senior pastor and First Lady, Dr. Frank, and Pastor Mary Ofosu-Appiah, we welcome you to All Nations Church, Kharis House, where we release potential in people by connecting them to God. This month, we have been encouraged to exercise our faith for exploits and also know the word to help us in this regard. Our highly anticipated leadership conference, Iron Sharpens Iron, ISI 2023, is just around the corner from July 19th through the 23rd. Don't miss out on this incredible opportunity to be inspired by a stellar lineup of speakers like Frank Ofosu-Appiah, Mensah Otabil, Janae Alcorn, Mary Ofosu-Appiah, Courtney McBath, and Sam Chan. Businessmen, ministry leaders, pastors, and the youth. This is for you. Don't miss it. Even if you can't join us in person, you can still register and receive additional updates via email on how to participate virtually. Registration is now open. Visit advancedlife.org to secure your spot and unlock a world of knowledge. Community Engagement Outreach Department is calling for all volunteers. Interested in joining the department to kindly meet with Evangelist Beebe in the fellowship hall by the kitchen after service. There will be a memorial service for Madam Agatha Chie on July 1st at 781 Athens Highway, Loganville, from 6 to 11 p.m. She was the mother of Akusia, Anna, and Mary Chie. Church, let's support our sisters as they celebrate their mother's life. Rush to the Manor Bookstore, located here at Kharis House, and Amazon for your copies of bestsellers from our very own Dr. Frank Ofosu-Appiah, and also gift items. Remember to stay connected by subscribing to our YouTube channel, All Nations Kharis House, for weekly updates and inspiring messages. Also connect on social media platforms for updates and happenings for the week. My name is Sonia Fisher, and this is the ANC News.
For more information, please visit our website at allnationsusa.com or simply call the church office at 770-923-8383. Subscribe to our YouTube page, like us on Facebook, and follow us on Twitter. Stay blessed.
Amen. Let's put our hands together for Kharis expression. Wow. God richly bless you. We have two baby dedications quickly there. Yeboa family and the Otumfo family. Let's put our hands together for them. Bishop says it every time that anybody that stands here for baby dedication has a story. Has a story. God has been good to these families. They went and they came back healthy. And so we are grateful to God. Bible says that children are a heritage to the Lord and the fruit of the womb. It says reward. And so we bless God for the we bless God for the Yeboah family, and we bless God for Otunfo family. Amen. Her name is Nako Ewura Efua Otunfo. Nako Ewura Efua Otunfo. Amen. Father, we thank you for the blessing that you have given to the Otunfo family. This morning, we are grateful to the gift of joy, the gift of peace that you have given to them. We commit Nako into your capable hands. You gave Nako to them, and they are giving it back to you. In the name of Jesus, I bless you, Nako. From the crown of your head to the soles of your feet, I bless you in your going out and in your coming in. From today, as you grow, I am praying that sickness will be far from you. Disaster will be far from you. You will grow into the woman that God has purposed and ordained for you to be. Nako, I pray for you that at school, amongst the best, you will be the best. I pray that any evil eye, any evil agenda over your life, over the purpose and the plans that God has for you, will not come to pass. Nako, I bless you today. And I commit you back into the capable hands of God. I commit you back to God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. Increase in every way. Increase in every way. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Abena Adansi Yeboah. Abena Adansi Yeboah. Father, we thank you for the gifts of life. Thank you for Abena. Thank you for the gifts that you gave to the Yeboahs. They are grateful to you for the gifts of life. Today, they have come into your presence to bring back the gifts that you have given to them. I pray for you, Abna, that the Most High God will always be on your case. No accident, no plan of the enemy will come near you. I am praying for you, Abna, that you will grow in grace. You will grow in strength. The hand of the Lord will be over you. And I pray for you that at school, amongst the best, you will be the very best. You will increase on every side, to the left and to the right, in the name of Jesus. I pray, oh God, that because of you, your family will know peace. Because of you, your family will know joy. From today, I dedicate you back to the capable hands of God. I dedicate you in the name of the Father, the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Congratulations. Amen. Let's put our hands together for them as they take their seats.
Hallelujah. Amen. What do we say to mommy? God bless you. God bless you. God bless you for such a powerful word. Worship. Amen. And what do we say to Kharis worship? Wow. Kharis expression. That's right. Kharis worship. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. We are grateful to God this morning for the great work they are doing in this house. Amen. Is anyone here for the very first time? Today is your first Sunday with us. We want to recognize you. I see some hands waving over here. Wow. Wow. Thank you for coming. We know you came by a number of churches to get here. And so before you got here, our bishop has prepared something special for you. We want to hand that gift over to you before you leave. So if you are able, get your stuff together and see the ladies in the aisle. They will hand that gift to you. Shall we clap for them as they make their move towards them? Clap for them. Keep on clapping. 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 Wow. Keep on clapping. Keep on clapping. Yes, yes, yes. We thank God that they made it here today. Hallelujah. There's something new in the house. Amen. Papa told us, you look on the floor, you see it, right? Awesome, awesome. So, ISI is just around the corner. Amen? Amen. How many of us have downloaded the app? Now, I want to see by hand. Okay. Some are not sure whether you have it or not. And how many of us has registered? Registration. Registration. Oh, this is in-house. Hallelujah. Amen. So we want to encourage you to register. Amen. Papa says that in every one of us, there is a leader. Come and sharpen your leadership skill. Amen. So whatever it takes, like he has been saying to us, the people that are coming, they are loaded. Amen? And because they are loaded, we want to partner with Papa and Mommy. He told us the other day that for the last 19 years, they have been sponsoring it. Do we have some partners in the house? Hallelujah. So register and don't only pay the registration, but also bring an offering, bring a partnership gift. Hallelujah. Do we have some people who will do that in the house? Seriously. We want some partners to partner with Papa and Mommy. Amen? So let's make our process to make it possible for us to be part of this ISI. It's just around the corner. Amen. Amen. Each one bring one is still on. How many of us have been doing it? Okay, I see some hands. So those of us, we are only halfway through the year. You still have the opportunity to do that. So please, if you haven't been doing it or you haven't done anything, it is time. The cards are available for you to do that. Amen? Amen. Each one bring one. Monday, Wednesday, Friday, we meet here. We meet on the prayer line to pray. Join us 5:30 in the morning and let us pray. This coming Friday, we will not have a prayer meeting. Saturday, we have glory hour. So Saturday, 6 a.m., we are meeting here to lift our prayer. We are bringing the first half of the year to a close as we enter into the second half. So whatever it takes, let us show up on Saturday, 6 a.m. It's just for an hour and a half, and we'll be out of here. Amen. Amen. So make it a plan to show up Saturday morning. There will be no activity here Friday evening. The family of Ohini Asiedu, they are here to say thank you. Hallelujah. Amen. Yesterday we had a funeral here and they want to say thank you to the Lord and to the house. Amen. Hallelujah. I'm not a very good public speaker. So they put me on the spot here, so I have to say something. About 2 weeks ago, we lost an uncle, a father, a husband, a friend, and everything. It came as a shock to the family. We're still grieving. And one thing that struck out was, in time of situations like this, that's when you realize the power of a community or society. Human beings by nature are social creatures. And we receive phone calls offering support and condolences. We really appreciate everything that each one of you did. But we are here this morning to offer a special thank you to All Nations Church, especially to the pastor and the first lady. They've been very instrumental in giving us all the support that we needed. And also to some of the members, there are so many that I don't even know their name, but they've been there for us during this period. It's been about 5 years since my auntie and the husband, they came to church. So normally you might think, people might have forgotten about them, but you guys show up and, gave us everything that they needed. So we are here to say a big thank you to everybody. We really appreciate, what you've done for us.
Thank you. Shall we stretch forth our hands and pray with them? Father, we commit the family of our brother into your hands. We ask that, Lord, you continue to strengthen them, empower them, preserve, protect them, cover them, continue to support them in every way. We pray that whatever is ahead of them, you give them the grace to continue, and let the joy of the Lord be their strength in times like this. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Thank you. Thank you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Shall we have our declaration? Shall we have our declaration? Shall we be upstanding? And this declaration is not ordinary, so speak it, declare it, and let it be part of you. We are still waiting to see the one who will speak it and declare it without looking on the screen. Shall we go? I declare. Because the life of God indwells me, I'm empowered to do extraordinary things. Limitations, barriers, and resistance will not contain me or hold me back. Extraordinary acceleration, abundant goodness, and uncommon harvest will come to me speedily. Declare that because from strength to strength and glory to glory, as I serve the purposes of God in my life, apathy, mediocrity, and stagnation will never be my portion. As I press into great exploits, I walk in dominion in all areas of my life because God's hands are upon me. I fear no evil, I do not worry, and I'm not timid because his promises over me are sure. The dry places in my life will be filled with singing and laughter as God gives me new life for exploit. I declare that because he has made me an ambassador of the kingdom, a solution and not a problem. I'm a barrier breaker, I'm a world changer, I am built for exploit. Amen. Amen. So upon this declaration, Father, we make our journey. We pray that your presence, O God, will be with us all the way throughout this week until we meet again. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Please, if you are a mother here, I want you to pick up your bag. Follow me to the fellowship hall for 1 minute, please. If you are a mother here,